Hello, my name is Alvin Jurcic. I'm coming from the Kamptal in Austria, and I want to have a glass of wine with you and tell you a little bit about what's happening back home in the Kamptal region. Together with my wife, we took over the old traditional family winery of my parents. The winery itself, old crazy long history. We are working in a 700-year-old cellar digged by the monks, an ancient monastery cellar. And it's quite cool for us, for young people, working in this kind of museum atmosphere. And we learned that tradition, it's a cool base you can work on, you can start with. But we never wanted to fall asleep in tradition. So our mission basically is to open our eyes, to open our mind, to go out and check out the soils and trying to define what can be the new classic in the Kamptal region. And right now, I must say, we are working more like the tradition of my grandfather, but also it's getting more and more important for us. How can we define our style of Grüner in a way that will fit into the future? And in our case, I'm the guy out in the vineyard. I'm taking care of our vineyards, working in organically, with organic practice. Stephanie, my wife, she's the cellar master. And so we are quite, the good thing is that the both of us, we have the same taste. We were drinking for years together to develop a base of where we can say we taste the same, but never losing the idea of what's the identity of the Kamptal region. How can we make wines as unique as possible? I brought you a Grüner Veltliner from back home. It's a Erste Lage from a vineyard called Dechant. Erste Lage, it's our Premier Cru classification. And in this case, we harvest late, but not too late. We harvest our grapes when they taste ripe, but not overripe. So it's a hell of a work during harvest for me, jumping from one vineyard to the other by just tasting grapes and deciding it's on the point or it's not al dente yet. We have to wait for another couple of days. But I want to make a Grüner Veltliner and not overpowered yellow Veltliner style. After harvesting the grapes by hand, we make a maceration of the skins for up to 2 days. Then we press. It's very simple. We go to our big old oak barrels. In the meantime, we use Austrian oak. We kicked out all the new oak. We don't want to make wines with any kind of aromatization. And the idea is, what can you get rid of and still make a great wine? How can you reduce yourself to find the pureness of your vineyard? And so we are not only doing one Premier Cru, we are working on 5 different Premier Cru soils. But in the cellar, we all do the same way. We want to find out the silent voice of terroir by not overpowering the wines in the cellar. And after 10 to 11 months on the full lease with no batonnage, then it's time for the bottling. And then you can enjoy the wine. Cheers.